A very good morning, dear students. In this video, I am going to explain about another important concept of organic chemistry, that is electron displacement effect. Okay, so displacement is nothing but movement. So due to movement of electrons, so some kinds of effects can be arised. So those are known as electron displacement effect. So here you may get a doubt, why electrons are moving? So because to make a reaction or to participate in reaction, either breaking of bond or making of bond should take place. To make a bond or to break a bond, electron should move from one atom to other atom or from one place to another place. So that means they are involving in movement. Okay, which are involving, only electrons are involving in movement. Due to the movement of such electrons, here different kinds of effects are arise. Those are known as electron displacement effects. So here four different types of electron displacement effects are there, that is inductive effect, electromeric effect, resonance effect and hyperconjugation. Okay, inductive effect, electronic effect, sorry, electromeric effect, resonance effect and hyperconjugation. So these are the four different types of electron displacement effects where we can see these in organic compounds. Okay, first we'll see what is electromeric effect. So electromeric effect, so this one I am taking because it is the easiest one to understand, it will become very easy, so that I am taking the second one, that is electromeric effect. So what is electromeric effect? See here, the complete transfer of electron to one of the bonded atoms. Okay, so here two atoms are present, just imagine A and B, between them some electrons will be present. Okay, so now these two are bonded by a bond. Okay, now whenever these electrons are completely transferred to either of the atom, either to A or B, on demand of attacking reagent. Okay, so on demand of attacking reagent, some Z reagent is coming, just imagine. So whenever it attacks to this A or B, okay, A or B, due to the demand of attacking reagent, okay, due to the demand of attacking reagent, if electron displacement is taking place, okay, these electrons are displaces either to A or B, then that type of effect is known as electromeric effect. It is a temporary effect. Remember, it is very important. Electromeric effect is a temporary effect. Why it is temporary? Only it is due to the attacking agent. This is known as attacking reagent. Okay, if attacking reagent is there, then only electrons displacement can take place. If there is no such kind of attacking reagent, the electron sharing between these two atoms do not shift towards any atom. If it is present, then only electron displacement will take place. As soon as the attacking reagent is removed, there is no displacement of electrons will take place in a compound. So that this is said to be temporary effect. Okay, only due to the demand of this attacking reagent, displacement of electrons takes place either of the bonded atoms. As soon as attacking reagent is removed, this displacement cannot take place, so that we can say it is a temporary effect, which is very important. You have to remember this point. Electromeric effect is a temporary effect because it cannot be arised if there is no attacking reagent. Okay, it is due to only demand of attacking reagent, so that we can say it is a temporary effect. So there are two types of electromeric effect, that is positive electromeric effect and negative electromeric effect. Positive electromeric effect and negative electromeric effect. First we will see what is positive electromeric effect. When pi electrons are transferred, just imagine, when pi electrons are transferred on the same atom on which attacking agent or reagent attack is known as positive electromeric effect. So that means, for example, here I am taking C double bond C, that is alkene. When it is added by, just imagine, H plus. It is added by H plus. So if an atom or a species is containing positive charge, that attacking reagent is known as electrophile. It is known as electrophile. So it is lack of electrons. It tries to accept the electrons, whatever the species containing the property to accept electron, those are known as electrophiles. Now this is electrophile. Just imagine it is going to attack to this carbon atom. Okay, see, when pi bonded electrons are transferred on the same atom, to which the reagent attack. Now the reagent is attacking to this atom, so the pi bonded electron should transfer to this atom. Okay, why electrons should transfer here? Because H plus is lack of electrons, so there is no electron on the hydrogen electrophile or proton. Okay, it tries to attack the position wherever the electrons are more. Okay, here two bonds are present. This is one bond, this is another bond. If two bonds are present, a double bond is present. One is sigma, other one is pi. Okay, now pi bonded electrons are shifting to this carbon atom. Whenever it takes this electrons, electron contain which charge? Negative charge. Okay, now this carbon is taking electron, so it will get which charge? Negative charge. Carbon gets negative charge. To this negative charge, attacking agent can attack very easily, then converts into two bonds are there in this on this carbon atom. Now double bond is converted to single bond because pi bonded electrons are moved to this carbon atom. Now on this carbon atom, two bonds already existing, newly hydrogen is added. Now there is no positive charge on hydrogen. Why? Because that positive charge is neutral by the negative charge present on the carbon atom. It is balanced. Okay, it is balanced. By taking this extra electrons, positive charge on the hydrogen is balanced, no positive charge. Now which atom is losing electron? See, this pi bonded electrons are equally sharing between these two carbons. Whenever these two electrons are taken by only this carbon atom, this is losing electron, this is gaining electron, so that I have represented here negative charge, and here it is losing electron, so this carbon will get positive charge. Okay, and this effect is known as positive electromeric effect. Why it is positive? Because the pi bonded electrons, these are pi bonded electrons, are transferred on the same atom. This is the atom where it is transferred, on which a reagent attack. Now the reagent attack on the same carbon atom. Okay, to that carbon only pi bonded electrons are transferred. So the effect is known as positive electromeric effect. Now whenever this hydrogen is eliminated as H plus again back, okay, what happens? This bonded electrons make a pi bond here, positive charge and carbon neutralizes and give back this alkene. That means as soon as the attacking reagent is removed, displacement of electrons cannot be takes place, so that it is known as temporary effect. Okay, it is temporary effect because it is arised only due to the attack of attacking reagent. Okay, this is known as positive electromeric effect. Now move on to the negative electromeric effect, second pi. See, in this electromeric effect, pi bonded electrons are transferred away from the atom to which the reagent is attacked. Okay, to which the reagent is attacked. Now I am taking one of the example for this, that is C double bond C alkene. Now this alkene is attacked by CN minus, that is cyanide. Okay, it is one of the functional group. Due to containing negative charge, whatever the species or atom which is containing negative charge, that is known as nucleophile. Okay, this nucleophile with extra electrons, where it is going to attack? Wherever electron density is less. Okay, that means if there is a positive charge or electron density is less, there it is going to attack. Understand? So, see here, just imagine if it is going to attack to this carbon atom. Here two carbons are present. If it is adding to the first carbon atom, then pi bonded electrons should transfer away from that atom. Okay, it should transfer away. That means it moves to the another carbon atom. It moves to the another carbon atom because cyanide is coming with negative charge.
okay, that cyanide ion is added to the double bonded carbon containing less number of electrons. Okay, if it moves to this carbon atom, it gets negative charge, it gets positive charge. Okay, that means it is lack of electron. Positive charge indicates that it is lack of electrons. That means less number of electrons are present to that carbon atom. Now cyanide, this is attacking agent, it is going to add. Pi bonded electrons will move away from the atom to which the attacking agent is added. Now what will be the product? Two bonds on this carbon atom is represented. Now double bond converted to single bond. Now this carbon atom is again with two bonds and cyanide is added. Okay, now there is no negative charge on cyanide. Negative and positive charge, these two are balanced by making this bond. Okay, now this carbon is getting electrons because of movement of pi bonded electrons, so it will be having negative charge. Understand? As soon as the cyanide ion is removed, negative charge will make a pi bond here and we will get back this alkene. That means this effect is a temporary effect. Only due to the involvement of attacking reagent we can see this effect. If a nucleophile attacks any atom, the transfer of electrons will take place away from the atom to which the nucleophile is added. Okay, then that type of effect is known as electromeric effect. So electromeric effect is a kind of electron displacement. Is electrons are displacing? Yes. So that it is known as electron displacement effect and it is a temporary effect. Because of the involvement of attacking reagent only, we can see this electromeric effect. Now we'll see the second type. Now we'll see about the second type of effect, that is inductive effect. Inductive effect is also a kind of electron displacement. Even in this effect we can see electrons displaces, electrons moves from one place to another place, then that is known as inductive effect. Remember, this inductive effect deals with only sigma electrons. It deals with only sigma electrons, whereas electromeric effect deals with only pi bonded electrons. Okay, but inductive effect deals with only sigma bonded electrons. So first we'll see the definition of this inductive effect. See here, the shifting of bonding electrons. Okay, here electrons involved in bonding. The shifting of bonding electrons of carbon chain, towards or away from an electron withdrawing or electron releasing group attached to carbon chain is called inductive effect. Okay, your shifting of bonding electrons are taking place. So it is shifting either towards or away from the electron withdrawing or releasing group. That means your carbon chain is containing either electron withdrawing group or electron releasing group. Okay, either towards these two groups or away from these two groups, if electrons shifts, which electrons? Bonding electrons are shifting, then that is known as inductive effect. This inductive effect is a permanent effect. Inductive effect is a permanent effect. Now see, this is the carbon chain. Okay, this is the carbon chain. Now to this carbon chain, here one X atom is attached. Just imagine this X is an electron withdrawing group or donating group. Now I have taken it as electron withdrawing group. Okay, that means it will take these bonded electrons towards itself. Now this X is attached to carbon chain. Is it in a chain form? Yes. See, again I am writing one more carbon atom. To this carbon chain, now one of the atom is attached. That atom may be electron withdrawing or electron donating or releasing group. Now I have considered this X as electron withdrawing group. That means it will take electrons. Okay, which electrons? Bonding electrons. Now here only single bond is present, right? And even here single bond is present. If a single bond is present, obviously that is a sigma bond. Now the sigma bonded electrons between carbon chain and the X electron withdrawing group is trying to taken by electron withdrawing group. It is trying to taken by electron withdrawing group. So it is not completely, okay, it is partial movement of electrons. Partially the sigma bonded electrons are shifting towards electron withdrawing group. So it is taking electrons, it will get negative charge. Okay, partially it is taking, so we will represent it with delta. So delta negative indicates that partial negative charge. It is not complete displacement. If it is completely moved towards this X atom, that is indicated by complete negative charge. But here only partially, that means if see, this is carbon and X bond, I have taken only this bond. Okay, if these two are sharing electrons equally, then it should be present at the center. Whenever this pulls electrons towards itself, then that bonded electrons move close to the X. Okay, it will be present like this. That means it is moving away from the carbon and moving towards the halogen. So it is not completely breaking. Okay, it is just moving partially, so that it will get partial negative charge, it will get partial positive charge. Are you clear? See here, X atom is attached to carbon chain. Between carbon and this X atom, a bond is present. So shifting of this bonding electrons will take place towards the X atom because it is electron withdraws. That means it takes the electrons towards itself partially, so that it will get partial negative charge and the carbon will get partial positive charge. Okay, remember this inductive effect is applicable to the carbon chain till 4 carbon atoms. So this inductive effect can be applicable to the carbon chain till 4 carbon atoms. That means it is influenced even on the second carbon atom. Though it is not attached to the halogen or the X atom directly, even it will faces some partial positive charge. But that partial positive charge is very less when compared to the first carbon. This is first carbon, second carbon, third carbon, fourth carbon. Whenever the distance between the electron withdrawing group and the carbon increases, partial charges gets decreases. So it is also facing partial positive charge, that is less than the first carbon. So that here I have represented two deltas. These two deltas indicates that it is a partial positive charge. Even on the third carbon atom, we can see some positive charge, that is still less than the second carbon. So we can represent it with partial positive charge. Okay, even on the fourth carbon will be present. From fourth carbon onwards, there is no this inductive effect influence. Okay, it is applicable only till 4 carbon atom. After 4 carbon atom, such positive charge on the carbon chain will not be present. Okay, this movement of here, this electrons are moving towards this X atom. Yes, displacement of or shifting of sigma bonded electrons from the carbon atom towards or away. Okay, towards or away from the electron withdrawing or releasing group is known as inductive effect, and it is a permanent effect. Remember, inductive effect is a permanent effect. Okay, because this electron withdrawing or releasing group is present along with the carbon chain, so we can say it is a permanent effect. Okay, now inductive effect is again of two types, that is negative inductive effect and positive inductive effect. First we'll see what is negative inductive effect. This is very important concept. Listen carefully. If you have any doubt, I'll repeat once again, listen carefully. So this is only dealing with sigma bonded electrons. If the bonding electrons shifting towards or away from the electron withdrawing or donating group attached to the carbon chain is called inductive effect, and it is a permanent effect. This is applicable only till 4 carbon atoms of the carbon chain, but after this 4th carbon atom there is no inductive effect. So this inductive effect is of two types, that is negative inductive effect and positive inductive effect. Okay, so in negative inductive effect, when an electron withdrawing group is attached to the carbon chain, Okay, so when an electron withdrawing group is attached to the carbon chain, then electron, then effect is called, then that effect is called negative inductive effect. That means here electrons move towards the electron withdrawing group. It will get partial negative, it will get partial positive charges. Okay, if when a electron withdrawing group is attached to the, this is electron withdrawing group, so only electrons are moving. So head of the arrow I have represented towards X, that means it is moving towards the X. Okay, is attached to the carbon chain, then that effect is called negative inductive effect, indicated by minus I effect. Okay, so here X means either carbon trifluoride, NO2 group, CN, cyanide group, CHO, C double bond O, that is ketone, acids, fluoride, chloride, bromide, iodide, hydroxy group or amine. So all these are electron withdrawing group. In place of X we can write Cl, in place of X we can write NH2, in place of X we can write OH. All are examples of electron withdrawing group. They will take electrons from the carbon chain, and all these are minus I effect groups. Okay, this is about the increasing, order of minus I effect. Okay, among all which is containing highest minus I effect, carbon trifluoride. Least minus I effect is for amines, that is NH2. You just remember this order. Negative inductive effect, where we can see when an electron withdrawing group, this is electron withdrawing group, is attached to carbon chain. In that case, we can see minus I effect or negative inductive effect. Okay. Now, the second one, that is positive inductive effect. When an electron donating, okay, that means it donates electrons to the carbon chain, or releasing group is attached to the carbon chain, then that effect is called positive inductive effect. Okay. When an electron donating or releasing group is attached to carbon chain, then that effect is called positive inductive effect. Here I am taking one of the carbon chain. Okay. To this, just imagine Z group is added. Okay. Now this Z is acting as electron donating group or electron releasing group. That means from Z, electrons are given to carbon chain. Electrons are given to carbon chain. Then this Z will get partial positive charge. It is losing electron, and carbon will get partial negative charge. In this case, okay, we can see positive inductive effect. Okay, positive inductive effect, when we can observe when an electron donating or releasing group is attached to the carbon chain, then that effect is called positive inductive effect. Now we'll see the order of this positive inductive effect groups. Okay, see, this is the positive inductive effect which is seen in this compound. Here Z is electron donating group attached to the carbon chain. In this case, we can see positive inductive effect. It releases electrons, it will get partial positive charge. It accepts electrons, it will get partial negative charge. All alkyl groups are examples of electron donating or releasing group. Here we have taken one of the compound, that is tertiary methyl carbon. Okay, so tertiary carbon atom, because on this carbon 3 methyl groups are present. Whenever number of alkyl groups are present, electron releasing property also increases, positive inductive effect also increases. We can also write this compound as C upon C 3 methyl groups. Here 1 methyl, here 1 methyl, and here 1 methyl is present. Now on this carbon atom, okay, positive inductive effect increases, because it donate electrons, even it donate electrons, okay, even this carbon donate electrons. If all the three carbons, see, I'm writing this structure here clearly, okay, listen. So this carbon, okay, on this carbon atom 3 methyl groups, 3 methyl groups are present. CH3, CH3, CH3. Okay, on this carbon now positive inductive effect increases, because this methyl group is a donating group. It donate electrons to this carbon.
even it donate electrons to this carbon. Even this is alkyl group donate electrons. At a time all the three are donating electrons, then upon this positive inductive effect increases. Okay, see the next compound, CH. Okay, on this carbon two methyl groups are present. I am writing those two methyl groups like this. Okay, now on this carbon atom, positive inductive effect is little less when compared to this, because here only two donating groups. This is one donating group and this is another donating group. Hydrogen do not donate electrons. Okay, only two are donating. So it is containing little less inductive effect, positive inductive effect than this. Okay, this is containing more positive inductive effect. How this positive inductive effect increases? With increase in number of alkyl groups. Whenever number of alkyl groups increases, automatically positive inductive effect also increases. See, in this third one here, this carbon is attached with only one methyl group. It donates only one pair of electrons, so that it is containing less positive inductive effect than this, and it is containing more positive inductive effect than methyl group, because all the three on this carbon atom, three hydrogens are present. Okay, these three hydrogens do not donate any electrons. They don't have the property to donate electrons. Then there is no electron shifting. So it is containing least positive inductive effect among all. Among all, which is containing highest positive inductive effect? Tertiary carbon is containing positive, more positive inductive effect than secondary, than primary, than methyl. Okay. So this is about the types of inductive effects, that is positive and negative inductive effects. Next, applications of inductive effect. So in which ways we can use this inductive effect can give about applications, uses of inductive effect we can also say, or applications of inductive effect. The first application is that it can explain the stability of reactive intermediates. What are reactive intermediates? That is carbocation and carbanions. Okay, stability of this carbocation and carbanion we have seen in last classes. Okay, such stabilities of carbocation and carbanion can be explained based on the inductive effect. Okay, see, positive inductive effect increases, plus psi effect increases stability of carbocation. Okay, plus psi effect increases stability of carbocation but decreases stability of carbanion. See, this is carbocation. Now this carbon is with positive charge. When it will get positive, when it will get stability, whenever the positive charge neutralizes, then only it will get stability. To neutralize this positive charge, it require which charge? Negative charge. So this methyl group is electron donating group, releases electrons. Even it is a electron donating group, releases electron. Even this is electron releasing group, donates the electrons. When all the three donates electrons, then positive charge on this carbon soon get neutralized. Okay, it disappears as early as possible, because it contains three electron donating groups on it. So it is containing more stability. Here three, whenever plus psi groups increases on carbocation, so plus psi effect increases stability. When plus psi groups increases, stability of carbocation also increases. But in this case, only two alkyl group, plus psi group, this is plus psi group, this is plus psi group, only two are present. When compared to this one, here the stability is less, because number of plus psi group is decreased. Here three plus psi groups are present, here only two. So its stability is less when compared to this. Okay, now here, so this is containing less, more stability than this one, because this carbocation. Why it is carbocation? Because carbon contains a positive charge, so it is known as carbocation. So this carbocation contains only one plus psi group. Okay, so compared to this one, this is containing minimum or less number of plus psi group. So its stability is less when compared to this. Now compare these two, methyl carbocation, ethyl carbocation. This methyl carbocation is not with any
alkyl group or plus I group. Zero plus I group, no plus I groups. Okay, so its stability is very less when compared to ethyl. Okay, this is called tertiary carbocation. This is secondary, primary, and methyl carbocation. So this tertiary carbocation is more stable because of increasing in number of plus I group. Whenever plus I group increases, stability of carbocation also increases. Okay, and whenever plus I groups increases, stability of carbene ions decreases. And one more point here I have represented. Minus I effect increases stability of carbene ion and decreases stability of carbocation. Vice versa, it is opposite. Okay, whenever plus I groups increases, what happens? Stability of carbene ion decreases. See here, this is different types of carbene ions. This is tertiary carbene ion, secondary carbene ion, primary carbene ion, and methyl carbene ion. Okay, why it is tertiary? Because carbene ion is attached with three other carbons directly. But here, this is the carbon containing negative charge. It attached with only two carbons directly, so it is called secondary. In this primary carbene ion, only one methyl group is attached, so it is called primary carbene ion. And no alkyl group this, so it is called methyl carbene ion. Okay, if you see the stability of order of these three, see already this carbon is with excess of electrons. Okay, negative charge. So whenever it neutralizes negative charge, it gets stability. How to neutralize this negative charge? Whenever it will get a positive charge, that means it should lose the negative charge. Okay, whenever the electron withdrawing group is present, that will take this electrons, then negative charge neutralizes. But here, which group is present? Alkyl group. So such alkyl group is example of electron donating. Instead of taking, this methyl group donate electrons to carbene ion. Even this methyl group donate electrons to carbene ion. And third one also donate electrons to carbene ion. It is donating electron, it is donating electron, even it is donating electron, then negative charge on carbon more and more increases. Whenever negative charge increases heavily on the carbene ion, stability decreases. Stability decreases. That means it is less stable than the second one. Why? Here only two alkyl groups are present. This is plus I group, this is plus I group. Only two are donating. When compared to this, on this carbene ion, electron density is somewhat less. So that its stability is more when compared to tertiary carbene ion. Okay. Now, primary carbene ion. Here only one alkyl group is present. Then the presence of negative charge on this carbene ion is less when compared to this one. So this is more stable than this one. Okay. This is less stable than this one. There is no more alkyl group on this methyl carbene ion. So the carbon is attached with three hydrogens. No hydrogen can donate or accept electron. So only one negative charge will be present on this carbon atom. It is highly stable than this one, and this is less stable than the methyl carbocation. That means when plus I groups increases, stability of carbene ion decreases. When plus I groups increases, stability of carbocation is increases. So this is about the first application of inductive effect. By using inductive effect, we can explain about stability of reactive intermediates. Okay, whenever plus I group increases, stability of carbocation increases. Plus I group increases, stability of carbene ion decreases. Now we'll see the second one. Now we will see the second application, that is acidity of carboxylic acids can also be explained based on negative inductive effect and positive inductive effect. Okay, so whenever negative inductive effect groups increases, acidity of carboxylic acid also increases. Okay, when negative inductive group is present, acidity of carboxylic acid increases. If positive inductive effect is present, acidity of carboxylic acid gets decreases. Okay, so when positive inductive effect is present, acidity of carboxylic acid decreases. That is second application. Third one, basicity. Okay, basicity. See,
positive inductive effect increases the basicity of amines. That we'll see in objective classes, these two applications. Okay, you just listen, remember these two points, that is enough for PU. Okay, positive inductive effect increases, basicity of amine also increases. Negative inductive effect decreases the basicity of amine. If negative inductive effect is present, it decreases the basicity of amine. You just remember these two points. We can use these two points while solving objective bits. Now it is not required. You just remember these two points, that is enough. Okay, now here I have mentioned a question related to inductive effect. So two carbon ions I have taken here. Okay, now among these two, which is containing more stability, that we want to find out. See, here NO2 group is present, here ethyl group is present. So NO2 group is an example of which kind of group? Minus I effect group. That means it is electron withdrawing group. It withdraws the electron. That means NO2 take electrons from the carbon chain. It takes electrons from the carbon chain. Then it will get partial negative charge. It will get partial positive charge. And it is applicable till 4 carbon atoms. That means even it influences on the second carbon, then it will get partial positive charge. Now this partial positive charge, negative charge neutralizes and stability of this carbon ion increases. But here ethyl group is present. It is one of the alkyl group which is an example of electron donating group. It donates electrons to the carbon ion. Then negative charge on the carbon more and more increases. Stability of carbon ion decreases. Okay, among these two, this is more stable than the next one. Because here to this carbon ion, minus I group is attached. See, here I have mentioned a point. When minus effect increases, stability of carbon ion also increases. When minus I effect increases, stability of carbon ion also increases. That is what we have taken here. Minus I effect is present, so stability increased. Here plus I effect, this is an example of plus I group, so stability decreased. So that is about inductive effect. Remember, inductive effect is a permanent effect, electromeric effect is a temporary effect. Electromeric effect deals with pi electrons, inductive effect deals with the sigma bonded electrons. Very important concept. So if you have any doubt, you just pause the video and revise once again. Still, if you are getting any doubt, you can ask me in the Zoom meeting. Thank you.